As far as the peer review, which is required for this assignment, as I said, you will find a document in linked in the module called the peer review worksheet. It will say essay one, whatever that is that you're writing about. This is where you will title it. You'll put the writer's name and your name here. You will writer, if you have any specific questions you want your reader to answer, or place your essay, or places in your essay you want your reader to respond to, list them below. So the writer is actually capable of filling this out too. So there are things that you're like, I'm not entirely sure how I feel about this, or I'm not sure this is the right way to do this, or I don't know how this sounds. This is your opportunity to sort of point to your anonymous reader and say, can you look at this particularly? I feel like it's a tough area for me. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about this specific thing. Don't ask them to look at the entire paper and give you like revision. They can't do that as a peer review. What you can do is point to and say something like, I'm not entirely sure these three things are a good sources. What do you think, right? So again, remember, this is a rough draft. This is the developmental stage. As the reader for each of these, you'll read through the essay once without marking it or making any notes. The goal here, and I'm going to explain, this is why peer reviews are really important. People tend to want to make corrections immediately. They make what we would call surface level corrections. They see spelling words. They see sentences written in a way they don't value, or that they see misspelled words. This is the thing I was telling you about even as a grading professor. It's challenging because you see these things and you have to get yourself out of the habit of fixing them. One thing I do if a paper has enough errors in it that it's complicated to get through, I might run spell check once on it just to let spell check do what it needs to do to fix those kind of glaring omissions of the usage of spell check, and then I still do this next part. So even in a grading perspective, I'm doing a peer review with this part of the work. I'm reading through the essay once without marking it or making any notes. And what I'm doing is I'm asking myself some questions. The big one is, do I understand what they're trying to say? Do I feel like I can keep up with what they're saying? Do I feel like I get lost? I don't write anything down at that stage, but I read through quickly and I go, it sounds like a solid argument. The goal here is to see if they're contextually making sense. A bad way of seeing this is you will find that sometimes people are having one thought, but when they write it out, it comes out as four different thoughts. Well, when you do the initial read-through, you'll be able to tell right away something doesn't fit right. It doesn't mean to ignore it. It means now you've kind of got the right lens for what you're looking at. And then you will read through it a second time and respond to the following questions. After reading the entire essay, summarize in your own words the author's reaction, including the main ideas they're reacting to. Is the reaction narrow enough for you to easily follow? Do you have any suggestions for how the writer might narrow the focus of the reaction further? Now, the reaction is sort of their primary research. Like, are they making connections, or are they bringing in something that has absolutely no context whatsoever? For example, if I'm writing a paper on bicycle maintenance and I mention Nirvana 17 times, you might point out Nirvana is a band. It has absolutely nothing to do with bicycles. So that's kind of what happens in question one. You will mark a question in any place in the text that seems tangential or unrelated to the overall focus of the reaction, and explain in text why you think the section may stray from the focus. So this is carrying on that first part. If something stands out as being awkward, it doesn't fit, put a question mark and explain kind of what you see there. Don't tell them how to fix it. Just say, this doesn't fit here, right? Mark at least one effective piece of evidence, example, personal experience, personal observation, with a asterisk, and explain below why you found that evidence effective. Also note the most effective piece of evidence. This is the most, it's the third element in my peer review sheet, it's the one that I think has the most relevance to improving writing. Telling people what they did wrong is skill set that doesn't do much. Telling people what they did right is valuable. It helps you. It will help them. So the focus should be on pointing out the ideas where the points in the ideas where they go off in a different direction than their point. But use the asterisks and an explanation to say why they did really good, where there's something solid. Write more in at least one place where the essay could use more evidence, and then explain below what those places could use to allow the reader to relate and understand the author's reaction more easily. And then list below at least two strengths of the essay and explain why these aspects of the paper are working well. And then ultimately you will list your three main suggestions for revision. That doesn't mean revision of sentences. So don't worry about helping them fix their grammar or spelling. Think about it. If I'm talking about bicycle maintenance and I bring up Nirvana, a good suggestion would be to find a musician that is connected to biking culture. Like, I don't know, I mentioned it earlier, I think. I swear that Paul McCartney is known for riding bicycles. So maybe that would be a revision suggestion, is for me to find a musician that is connected to cycling so that at least I'm still having a conversation on cycling. So that's how that works. Where's my other sheet here? So this is kind of the rules, if you will, and these are all found in the files under the literature review for the LMS, for the class on Canvas. And this says something like, the least helpful comment to receive from peer review is, it looks okay to me. I'm gonna pause right there and really dig down here for a minute. I know it's easy sometimes to look at a paper and go, it looks good. It looks good enough that I don't feel like I can add to it, or I feel like the writer is stronger than I am, so I don't want to mess up their paper. I've heard all of these things. But ultimately, any input is helpful to a writer when it's from their peers, right? So we want students to find strengths or positive features in the draft, but we need to encourage them to be as specific as possible about both strengths and weaknesses. Other points of which you should remind students is they model giving effective commentary and peer review. Another way to say this is, these are different ways of looking at it, right? This is the best way to give effective commentary when you're talking to someone else about their writing. Always point out strengths as well as elements that need more work. If you always preface something with, this looks horrible, but I do like, that's not the way you want to frame this. You can always say, these are all the good things you're doing, and I see that these two things need help, right? So when we say strengths, we need to focus on those at first. They must be the most positive thing you can find. Try to attend to larger issues first, audience, purpose, organization, details. Talk about sentences, word choices, and punctuation only later in the peer review process if you really think that that's what you can draw, like that's an important thing to bring to the conversation. I would not bring it up immediately. That should not be the entire purpose of you doing a peer review. It's not to grammar check for them, right? Be specific. Point to particular places in the paper where revision will be helpful. Don't hesitate to respond as a reader, especially early in the review process. For examples, I got confused here. These are the kind of sentences you can use. I got confused here. I saw your point clearly here. I was convinced by your example or analogy or argument here, and highlight where that is. If you disagree with the comments of another peer review, say so. Not all readers react the same way, and divergent points of view can help writers see options for revision. Make comments in the spirit of helpfulness. Take comments in the spirit of helpfulness. Do not attack. Do not troll. Do not try to be offensive. Do not try to be funny or mocking or sarcastic or snide. None of those things will help in the peer review process. I know that, again, we're using a new model that I haven't used, which is the automated anonymous peer review system through the LMS. So I don't know if you'll actually get the opportunity to see another person's peer-reviewed comments, but hopefully if you do, you will take this as the spirit that I want you to bring to that conversation. And so that wraps up the peer review.